guys, not Monkey Gamer back here from that video. Guys, definitely welcome back to another episode of my snapping series. But real fast before I start, tell me how you guys like my thumbnails now. I'm kind of changing them up and I'm making new type of thumbnails for all my videos. Definitely tell me down below how you like them. But anyway, guys, this video is long awaited. I actually got a comment about this a long time ago. And if I sound funny or weird in any way, I have like a pimple on my bottom of my tongue. So that's why I might sound a little weird. I might, you know, it might not sound my normal voice. Sorry about that, guys. I might, I might say some words like, you know, incorrectly or something like that. So sorry about that. It hurts like all heck to talk right now, but I have to make videos for you guys because I love making videos for you guys. I know you guys love these videos. So that's why I'm still making videos, but it does hurt to talk. So anyway, as I was saying, this video is long awaited. It's going to be how to snipe if you only have 20k or less. So if you're starting off and you know, because a lot of times sniping methods, they're kind of geared toward you have a lot of coins. And the whole, you know, idea of sniping is, you know, if you have a lot of coins, you can put a lot of coins into it and you can get a lot back. Now, obviously, we do have my Super Bowl method, sniping method. If you guys have not seen already, go back to my channel and check it out. But today what we're going to be doing is just the basic sniping because, again, this is if you only have 20k. You're not going in, you know, you're not going in with all these coins, so you kind of have to, you know, try your best without spending a lot of coins. So, basic methods, again, is just going from all offense, elite, and then bears, and then going to the next team after this. So, just basic method, and what you really want to look for, guys, is chemistry. So, as you see, vertical chemistry right here. Sometimes people just look up how much Andrew Whitworth is going for, and they'll see you go for 5,500, they put them up for 5,400. And the whole idea what you want to look for is right here, DT, so deep threat chemistry. If we look at right here, this is vertical, right? So if we see a DT at 5,400, we know we can buy it right away and sell it for 6,400. So that's pretty much what you want to do, guys, is just go through and look at these chemistries. These chemistries are huge because a lot of these cards, they have multiple different editions of the same card because of the fact they have different chemistries. You know, they have a card with, you know, one card and another card, same exact way, they look exactly the same, but they have an alternate chemistry. And a lot of people just throw them up for how much they're, you know, going for, technically not looking at what the chemistry version is going for. So that's something to look for whenever you're sniping, especially when you're this low on coins. Those kind of snipes happen a lot, and it's very efficient and it's very awesome because people just don't think about to look for what the chemistry version of their card is going for. They just want to look for, you know, what the normal version is or whatever, you know, the lowest version on the auction block is. And sometimes that's not the case for, you know, getting a good snipe. This is 1,400 coins. Yeah, I'll do it. Wait, no. My bad. I almost messed that up. That's the 86 overall edition, which, let's just sort it by rivers. I'll take it. I'll put it back up for 15k, and it most likely will sell. So, guys, later on today, sometime later, or you might, actually, it might be out when you're seeing this video. Pretty much what I'm going to do is I'm going to run down, again, how to overprice cards and stuff like that and how to snipe and stuff, you know, kind of more broken down examples on how to snipe. So definitely, if you were watching this video, continue watching this video and then once you're done, go ahead and go over to that video and check it out because I'm going to, you know, really break down what players to snipe, you know, what exact players to snipe because a lot of people say, oh, you should, you know, oh, you should snipe certain player, or say you should snipe, you know, any player you can, but nobody breaks down what's a snipe. And this is a good example right here, 6,400, 6,000. And as you see, if this card wasn't up and this was like zone 1-2, you could easily just buy this, and then the next one up with Slot Expert, you know, it's about, you know, 8K. So that's what you want to look for is the chemistries. And sometimes it gets a little glitchy and you kind of can't see what the chemistries are because sometimes you have to click on the card in order for it to load the chemistries. If it does, just click on the card. It will load the chemistries. But for example, 5,400. Let's see what the next Dez Bryant chain movers. I think it's 6,000. So let's see. Okay, so 5,000 is the cheapest, and then 5,400 is the next. Now, I will talk about, you know, what exact cards to snipe again in another video, but this is pretty much the best way to snipe. And the way you're doing this, guys, is you're looking for one thing right here. You know, all right, let's see if I can, let's break this down. All right, so as you can see, this is 770 coins. Minus that, I can easily make a profit. So, we're going to buy him for that price, and we'll sell him for 7,600. So, it's obviously with this method, the issue is you're waiting for your card to sell, and you know, you don't have many coins, so that is kind of an issue. Sadly, the silver method is no longer a thing. And obviously, I'm doing this at like 1 o'clock in the morning, which is not a good time, but most of my videos, I have to do at 1 o'clock in the morning. Due to other people in my house, you know, I gotta make sure the audio is all good, guys. So that's the issue with a lot of times, is I can't, you know, record at like 3 or 4 in the afternoon, which kind of sucks. But yeah, so let's actually see what the silver method is still going for, and let's see if it's actually decent. So silver packers are, it was, oh no, it was all offense. Alright, so silver packers were selling for 8k, now they're selling for nothing, and most silvers will be selling for nothing. But the one thing I look at, guys, is we might be getting a Man of the Month set. It's not confirmed in any kind of way, and obviously I don't know, but I'm just assuming we might be getting a Man of the Month set. So that might be a thing. The one thing I look at is how much are gold badges going for? Gold badges has to be going for crap. They have to be going really, really, yeah. So we have 3,200, which is actually, that's actually how much they go for. Let me do math. Let me do some math real fast, guys. How much are silvers going for? 6,800. Okay, they're going for like about the same. What I'm saying, guys, it's because golds are going for nothing. And there's a gold player set that has, you put gold players in and you get badges back, and right now if they're going for nothing, 5 golds equals 2 badges and it's guaranteed silver or better, so you're guaranteed 1600 coins if that's the case. And you can buy, yeah, it's only gonna cost you 2700 coins. You're guaranteed to make more than half your coins back, with the chance of getting a gold or elite that, you know, you can easily make a lot of coins back. Let's try this out, guys. So this actually could be the new method, especially until they release a set. Right now, there's no set, you know, that actually make golds valuable. So they're all just plummeting in price and they go for nothing. But if you guys can come on here and actually snipe some of these gold players, you could probably make a lot of coins off of this. Because honestly, at this point, like, if you can, you know, snipe these gold players and actually get some coins back, I mean, not get some coins back, you can actually make some good coins off these. Because if you can pull one gold badge, you automatically make your coins back. And if people are going to put these up for like 450 coins and, you know, 350, 250, and you can just come on here. And I mean, if you can complete the set for even cheaper than what I was talking about at like, you know, 2,000 coins, this actually might be the best method in the game right now. I mean, you might, if you can complete the set for less than 1,600, you're making your coins 10 out of 10 times back. And that's just a fact. Like, you, okay, I did not mean to rhyme there. That's just a fact. And you're going to make your coin back and everything's going to be great. Nah. Alright, but yeah, I'm like, you can honestly, if you can make coins back 10 out of 10 times, this actually might be the best. So, again, let's see. Actually, let me go back and see how much I have. Again, you only need to buy 5, which I don't know why I thought 10. I'm thinking about how the set used to be. Now that the set is only 5, what's the point of not doing this set? Like, this set honestly just might be free money. Okay, we'll see. Go to newest. Alright, so these, I bought these all for 550 and below. So I spent about less than 2,500 on this. I mean, I spent about probably $2,200 on that whole entire set, and I made back about I made it back easily the coins that I spent on it. Now I'm just gonna put this in a solo badge upgrade, and I'm gonna keep doing this. Guys, this is like free coins pretty much. I actually do have some gold I can just put on in this set. And that my badge just sold. So instantly I made back all my coins that I spent. Let me actually go to golds. I have a lot of golds. So I've been meaning to do this. So I guess this is probably the best time to do this is on a video for you guys to show you what I'm pulling out of these packs. So I'm not trying to put the Super Bowl players in the pack in these because they actually go for a good amount of coins. But let's see real fast. Guys. I'm not trolling. There's no EA fluking here. Let's see how much elite badges go for. But guys, this might be the best method to make coins. Wow. Okay, well, you heard it first. I just fishery found out the method to make a lot of coins in this game. And sniping is not it right now. It is doing these sets. Wow. I don't know how long I'm gonna make this video because I want to keep doing these sets on video to show you guys how, you know, good these pulls are. Now remember, you get a guaranteed silver better. So you get guaranteed you make half of your coins back. There's no like, you know, like, oh, well, you make some of your coins back. No, you guaranteed to make at least half your coins back. And even more if you can, get a good pull. And also if you can snipe them for, you know, very much or not that much. And the fact that people are throwing these cards up because golds have no value right now. It's a good day, guys. Alright. Let's see. I can't put a card in there. Okay. Can't put him in there. Jay Cutler? I can. How much am I gonna get back on this one? A gold? A silver. So I'm pretty much getting a free gold every single time. And those things sell for 3,500 coins a piece, so I don't mind that. This set, I haven't even thought about doing this set. Like, usually the set isn't worth it because gold cards went for so much. But now the gold cards go for nothing because there's no point even doing anything with golds. This set is secretly going to become the best set in the game. Alright, what did I pull out of this one? And each of these sets, technically speaking, would cost me 2,500 coins. So, for example, this is a good example. But the thing is, I can put these in here, and I can actually make coins back by just turning these into gold badges and then selling the gold badges. So, this is secretly a great method. I just didn't think of this for so long. I mean, I know a lot of you guys are probably going to comment down below and go, oh, I knew this method, and I was doing this method. Why did you tell people? I only tell people methods on how to make coins just so that I can help people make coins. I don't do it, you know, to hurt anybody who already is doing the methods. If I find a good method, guys, I'm going to share it with you guys so you guys know about it and you guys can make some good coins off of it. But this is actually not that bad of a method. And seems like a very consistent method. Now, if my elite badge could sell, that'd be awesome. I might put it up for lower in a second. But, yeah, I don't know, guys. You guys can tell me down below your opinion and what you guys are thinking about this method. Do you guys love it? Do you hate it? Do you think it's, like, you know, stupid or it's not worth it? Because if you can get these cards for 550 coins, which most of the time people are going to throw these up for very, very cheap, because gold cards have no set, you know, that actually make them expensive. This set right now is crazy, honestly. If I was spending exactly what I was talking about, how much these sets go for, I honestly would be making my coins back. Because, again, 2,500 coins is how much it costs to do this whole entire set. So, you know, if you buy five of these, 550 coins each, which I did in the beginning of the video, let me put this up below, because I think people are undercutting me. And with elite badges, I just try to sell them as quickly as possible. I don't really care about overpricing. you can't really overprice elite badges because there's nothing in elite, you know, there's no reason people are gonna pay more for an elite badge just because, you know, you put it up, because people put up elite badges all the time. There's nothing that can make elite badges, you know, be able to be overpriced. So that's why I don't care about overpricing elite badges, which I do on other, you know, cards. Now, same thing with my with this method. Now, the golds probably are the best idea to do, but again, you know, these might be okay. Bronzes probably won't be good at all, and they'll be useless, but silvers and golds definitely could be great. Wow, guys. I was just making this video, you know, just showing you guys how to snipe if you don't have that many coins, and it turned into now a amazing coin making method that is just honestly crazy at this point. Cause I didn't really think about this, you know. I didn't really think about, oh yeah, right now the gold cards have no value. What to do with them? Put them in the sets. Alright, let's go back. And now we're gonna actually do this. Now we have a lot more coins. We have about, we're gonna have about 35k after this. So let's go through, and again, just go, you want 550 and below. So for example, like this card, I should have bought that. I'm gonna go back and buy that Bills card. But yeah, so you want 550 and below. And let's do a calculator, right? Or let's do a calculation real fast. So we're making 550, right? Okay, I did not mean to do that. Alright, so we're gonna put him in the set. And then we're gonna go back. 550. Let's go back to the Bills guy and buy the Bills guy. Alright, and I don't know why people are not doing this method. This method is honestly, I didn't think about it too much. And yeah, so 550, now we're 1100 coins. And now we just go, you know, one all offense. We could actually go, you know, each team all offense, all defense, just to make sure we get the cheapest card, especially because right here we got 350. So about 350, that's about 1450 coins. And if you pull an elite badge, you pretty much make, you know, 10 times your what your profit back is. So if you pull an elite badge, you're pretty much just, you know, it's getting crazy with how many coins you're making back. So we have 550 again. 2000. And I think this might be the last card. Alright, my elite badge sold. So starting this video off, I know I did go through my binder and sold some cards from my binder. But still, it's pretty crazy. Because I was just showing you guys how, you know, what the odds of the packs are. Because those odds are pretty crazy. Alright, so let's show you real fast. That's how much I spent on this pack. I did all the math. This is how much I spent. These sell for 3,200 coins each. Guys, it's not rocket science here. This is crazy. How is this even... I don't even know why people aren't doing this method so much more. This method is crazy. Like, these cards are going for 550 and below, and people are throwing them up, not really caring, and just trying to, you know, get them sold, and you can easily just make coins back doing this. And if you pull an elite badge, you make 10, you know, you at least guarantee pretty much to make your coins back. So we bought this for 300 coins. Like this, I don't know why people aren't doing this more often. This is a crazy method. Because it's just so effective. 500 coins. Because, again, people pull packs all the time, guys. They get these golds. They're like, oh, they go for nothing. They just throw them up on the auction block. They don't care. And you just go on the auction block. And as you can see, you won't pull a gold badge every single time. But most of the times I pull these packs, I pull a gold badge. And with a gold badge means you make your coins back 100%. So this is honestly pretty crazy. I think I'm gonna make this video might be a little long, guys, because I'm gonna keep doing this. I'm gonna show you guys this method. Did I add the 500? Let me see. I think I added the 500. Okay. So what? 1850. I might have missed 500. If I did, I'll find out. I find out, because this one should be the last card. And 300 coins. Thank you so much, my man, for putting that up for 300 coins. Because now I can actually just... Alright, so I think I missed 500. I'm just going to add 500. So it might have been less than this, but I'm just going to add 500 just to be safe. But this is how much I spent. This is how much I spent, guys. These sell for about 3,400, 3,300 a piece. That's how much I spent. And this is actually a lot better than sniping because you don't have to, you know, spend that much. And now I get another gold badge. Yeah! Let's go! Another gold badge. 3,400. Another bad sold. These sell for 3,000. I spent about 2,600 on the set. This is honestly not, it's not even that crazy of a method. You would expect if I'm making this much coins, it would be this crazy, you know, method that it's just like, oh my God, how do you make that many coins? I might do a little coin, you know, counter in the left, right-hand corner of the screen just to show you guys how much I'm actually making off this. Because honestly, I probably shouldn't be buying the 550 cards because I could probably buy, not buy them and just get them for cheaper. Because people are just throwing these cards up, not even caring. And I'm just going to, you know, take advantage of this. I'm going to make as many coins as I can possibly. And honestly, if you do this during prime time hours when everyone's on, this is at nighttime, by the way, guys. So this is when not many people are on. So it's even better because not many people on, not many people are, you know, trying to, you know, go against me with these cards or stuff like that. So I saw this video with 20K. Okay, we should have one more card left. We're at 2,050 coins right now, by the way, guys. I'm just doing in my calculator right here. Alright, 500 coins. I will take that, my good man. And this is the last one. Do that. 2,550 coins, how much I spent on this. Gold badge sells for 3,000 coins. This is not a, you know, there's no edits, no cuts in the video, no crazy, you know, things, guys. Tell me this is not the best method. Tell me this is not the best method. I mean, especially I'm not going as try hard as I could. I could actually literally not buy any cards for less than 550, but I'm just doing it because I want to keep the video going. But I could probably find all these cards for less than 550 and probably find all these cards for like 400 and less. And people are throwing these cards up all the time. So I'll keep taking this, man. This is free coin. I made 20K this video, guys. This is crazy. But this is how easy it is to make coin sometimes. Whenever a big set leaves the game, it's literally the easiest thing to make coins with, because you can just go through and you don't even need to stop, guys. You can just keep going, keep making coins. And if solos are this good, I would love to see the solo that's this good, because there's no solo challenge that's gonna let you just constantly make coins, and all you have to do is buy these players off the auction block, put them up. And not only that, you know what else you're doing mutt rewards wise? You want to get the legendary tier right here. This is how you get the legendary tier. I actually did this in last year when I wanted to get legendary tier. I actually did this exact thing. Well, I just did this set. So I'm going to spend on it. Guys, I don't know why this. One thing, not only should you guys do this set because of... What kind of odds are these? Like, how many gold badges have I gotten in this video? And the silvers, you only sell them. You just put them in the gold badge upgrade and you keep going. But how many freaking gold badges have I gotten in this video? Because this has to be ridiculous how many gold badges I got. Like, this set, guys, is so freaking worth it. And many times, you know, I'll complain a lot in this game. And you see, I could have bid on that card for 450. Sometimes bidding on these cards are the best method ever. But yeah, so like, I don't know if EA turned up the odds. These packs used to be crap. If you guys have not seen my videos earlier this year where I showed off these packs, they were complete crap. Now, these packs are just crazy. These packs are just crazy. It's ridiculous how great these packs are. And honestly, I'm probably not even seeing the cheapest one up because I'm, you know, there's so many gold cards up on the auction block. So if I wanted to, I probably should sort this by even more. By even sort this by like a certain chemistry, because I could probably even see cheaper players up. So many people throw these cards up and they don't, honestly, they don't care how much they throw them up for. They just want to get them out of the binder. And guys, just sit here and make the coins. I mean, as you can see, my gold badges are selling left and right. I made 23K about this video so far. I don't know how long this video is, but this video is going to be a very long video, guys. Just saying, because I'm just going to keep doing this method and showing you guys how many coins I make off this method. Okay, I don't want to. There we go. How much I spent? It's too easy, guys. It's too easy. I mean, I spent 2,400. I made 550 coins back. And I'm going to put these into the upgrade set. And eventually, I'm going to get a gold badge that I can sell for another, you know, some more coins. And I'll make some more coins back. It's too easy. And, you know, I don't know why many people aren't doing this. I guess maybe because they want the big snipes or something like that. But I'll take these small snipes. Well, not even snipes, just, you know, going through and buying these cards and selling them for more. I'll take this all day. It's not difficult to do at all. You're not, you know, fighting against somebody to do this. You can just easily watch some YouTube, watch some Netflix, do whatever you want and not even worry. As you're just going through and, you know, you don't have to play solos. You don't have to do all this kind of crap. This set is crazy, guys. This set is honestly, This is a great set, and I, you know, earlier in the year, these odds were crap for this set. EA really has fixed it with this set. They fixed these odds of this set. And you know what, I gotta say, the odds of everything lately has been seeming like it has gotten better. So, very nice on EA's part, and I guess a lot of people maybe not doing this set because they don't think it's worth it because of the fact that, you know, these used to be crap odds. I used to not even get one gold badge out of this set. I used to get all silvers. And now, I'm just getting non-stop great, you know, one after another pulls. It's crazy, guys. Alright. Show you. That's how much I spent on this set. How much am I going to make back? Oh. Alright. So this time, alright, so these both technically sell, I technically lost 1,100 coins. So one time I lost coins, but technically speaking, I didn't lose coins because I can put these in this set and get a gold badge back. So let's see, 5 times 750, what's that, 5 times 8, 400. Why am I even trying to do math, guys? I have a calculator right here. Alright, 4,000. So actually, I probably should be selling these silver badges. So that's actually, you know, bad on me. But it's whatever. I'm doing a set so many times, I don't feel like selling the silver badges. Because silver badges take forever to sell. So to be honest, they probably sell about, you'll probably get about 700 back on all of them. So yeah, you probably get 700 back on all of them. Crap. Times five. So about the same amount of coins back on the golds. Or same, about the same amount. Alright, so obviously, sometimes you're going to get dud packs like that, two silvers. But as you saw from this video, guys, I've been getting, you know, a lot of gold badges. And gold badges, instantly, you get one gold badge, you make your coins back right away. And as you can see from this video, I've been getting my gold, you know, I've been getting gold badges left and right. And you could just say I'm getting lucky, but can someone really get that lucky that many times? That's, you know, that's all I'm gonna say, guys. Come on. This is a very, very good method, in my opinion. And I think it's one of the best because you keep consistently getting coins. Obviously, it's all about getting lucky. But I feel like, you know, you guarantee to get a silver. So there's no bronze badges. that you're going to get. You're not going to get any chance at a bronze badge. And because people are throwing these cards up left and right, you can easily just snipe these, or not even snipe them, just, you know, buy them off the auction block. And the reason why it's not sniping, because they're not really, you know, put up at a too low of a price. It's just what they actually go for. But you easily can get them for that, so it's pretty nice. And sometimes people put them up for 250 coins. And this is actually... Wait, is that the playoff edition? Oh, dang. You actually might sell. You might sell for more, but I'm just going to put them up. I'm just going to put them in the set. Because I'm not trying to sell them right now. 350. And this might be the last card. Or there might be one more I need. Nope. Unless I bought the whole entire complete set for. See? Instantly, I made back 800 coins. Technically, I made back 1600 coins because that silver badge, I'm going to put it in the set anyway, but if I did sell it, I could make back 1600 coins. So, guys, I don't know what else to tell you. If you know, people ask me all the time, how do you make coins? I mean, it's just, you know, you're seeing how many times, guys. I'm making coins off pretty much every one of these sets. And the thing is, let's say that one set I didn't make coins off of, it's all right because, you know, what did I lose? I spent about, you know, what, 2,500 on a set. I got two silvers, so technically speaking, I got about 1,400. So I lost 1,100. Okay, well, I make back, you know, 1,600 on the sets I do make profit on. So even though I might lose every, you know, now and then, oh, I actually have not been adding it up. But yeah, so even though I might lose, you know, coins on every set now and then, I'm making, you know, enough coins to cover those amount of coins I lose, plus get some more coins. So it's crazy, guys. It's a very crazy set, and I guess EA boosted the pack odds for this set, and, you know, maybe no one realized it, because right now, this set is unreal with how easy it is to make coins off of. And yeah, I wish they would have told everybody, hey guys, this set has boosted pack odds now, because obviously it does. I think I added an extra 5 somewhere, but 2,600 coins. And this one I did technically lose coins on. It's all right though, because all the sets I did pull, well, I actually, you know, made my coins back. It's all right. So, and also I can put those into and get a gold badge back quicker. All right, 450. Actually, I spent a little bit too much on that one anyway. That set, because 2,600. If you can, you know, these 450s are put up all the time, you could probably complete the whole entire thing for about 2,200 or less. And if that's the case, you can really make a lot of coins back, especially, you know, one gold badge, which, as you can see from this video, is not that difficult, or not, you know, there's not bad odds to get a gold badge. You can easily make a lot of coins from this. It's crazy how easy this is. I'm actually kind of skeptical on why this is so easy, to be honest, because this doesn't seem, it's not tough at all. It's not, you know, difficult to do. Wait, why are these, why? I don't know why they're so expensive. All right, so let's go to the Giants, 49ers, I mean. And this is probably a bad idea to do this at like 5 a.m. in the morning, but I can just imagine during the daytime, during, like, you know, prime time hours. God, this must be amazing, because people putting cards up every second then, and you can just probably go to the auction block and find, like, you know, so many cards for so freaking cheap. It must be a great time when you do it during that time, which I'm gonna do it probably during that time tomorrow. You'll probably make back, like, you know, way more than 30 or 40k. It would probably be easily a lot more coins than that. All right, my gold badges are selling, and I just bought that for, actually, no, wait, did I Did I mess this up? Alright. I think this is how much, I believe. Alright, now my pack luck's getting bad. Woo! EA knows how good I was doing, so now EA's kind of like, alright, we gotta calm it down with this one. Again, every time I pull two silvers, I make my coins back overall. So it's not like, you know, because I made so many coins off of this so far. So how many gold badges do I have in the auction box? I have one up right now. So currently, I have 44,000. So I saw this video with 20. Yeah, actually no, I started technically this method with 9. And I made back so far about 30K. Now I did, you know, do a lot. I did sell a lot of, not sell, but a lot of the first badges, packs I did was out of my binder. So technically, I'll go through and I'll try to figure out, you know, where I exactly started. But yeah, so far guys, very awesome method right now. It's working plenty for me, as you can see. So if you guys want an awesome method, you guys want to make some coins very quickly and easily, here's your method. Because these badge packs seem to be boosted. I don't know why they're boosted right now, because none of my packs are ever boosted. I shouldn't say that, because I did pull Jerry Rice this year, but I got one limited time only pull, and I probably will never get one again. Yeah. Shout out to that one limited pull guy. And I know someone's going to comment and say, "Well, I got no limited pull." Well, I'm going to be pulling about, you know, 3 million coins on both consoles, hopefully, for golden tickets this year. So if you want a limited, or want a golden ticket, I will be letting you guys decide what golden ticket we make and giving away that golden ticket. So if you don't, you know, you're like, "I don't get limited time pulls," whenever golden tickets do drop, if I do pull one, you guys get to decide who we make. And I'm hoping, I'm trying to pull one on both consoles, so that I can give one away for PS4 and one for Xbox One. And with that, you guys decide who we make and you guys get the chance to win one. Okay? See? There we go. There we go. We're back, guys. We're back with the good pack luck again. I don't know why we were getting a lot of silvers back to back. It's whatever, we still are making our coins. It doesn't matter. Even if we get, you know, I think we would have to get like 5 silvers twice back and back to back in order to lose coins. So, you know, we're making coins every single time no matter what. Very, very awesome time, guys. All right, so 500 coins. Next one we have, it's going to be 550. All right. And again, I don't know how long this video is going to be. Its video might be about an hour long. I don't know. We'll see after I get done this video how long this video actually ends up being. Most likely will be a longer video because of the fact that I'm just, you know, why stop, guys? You know, a lot of people, it's like, this is the method and we're just going to end the video here. Nope. I'm not going to end the video here. If I'm still making coins off this method, I'm going to show you guys how many coins I'm going to make overall. And obviously, it's not like, you know, everyone's going to see this method after I'm done it. So everyone, you know, can go ahead and go do it if they want. Obviously, if you don't think that this is going to work, you don't have to do it. It's just if guys would like to do it and not compare players. But yeah, if you guys want to do this method and you guys like the idea and you guys see that it's working, go ahead and do it. No one's stopping you, and you will make some coins off this method. How many coins you will make, it all depends on how long you take. And also, with this method, once again, you're able to get Mutt Rewards, Mutt Legendary tier, by doing this method. It's like a win-win, you know? Oh, wait. Not my phone down. It's a win-win. You get Mutt Legendary tier if you do this for a long time, this method, and you make coins. Sometimes. Obviously, these you don't make coins off of, but it's a whatever. Because you get a lot of, you know, you get enough gold badges that you're going to make your coins. Alright. Go to next one, and again, you go to, you know, all offense, all defense, and then you go from each team. Now, probably a better idea is go by each position. Would probably be the best idea to get the lowest, you know, coin snipes. But I'm just trying to, you know, do this not too quickly, but I'm trying to keep the video going, and I don't want to go through, you know, go try hard to get the lowest coins, because I'm still making my coins back on most of these, so, which is a very, very good idea. Very, very, very good sign. But yeah, so again, I'm just using a calculator. Any calculator, you don't have to use a calculator. I just like to use a calculator because then I can see exactly how many coins I'm making back. But obviously, if you don't want to use calculator, you're like, I don't like calculators. Don't use a calculator. It's all up to you guys. You guys don't have to use one, but you can. Now, if you are enjoying the video so far, guys, make sure you slap that like button and you subscribe to the channel if you are new, because that's the fastest way to get notified for new content. And if you want to become part of the notification squad, click that little button once you hit my channel and you go to subscribe. Make sure you click that little button, a little bell next to the subscribe button, and that will make you a part of the notification squad. And that means you will be notified whenever new videos release. So if YouTube somehow doesn't put it in your sub box, or you know, you can't check your sub box, or you don't know when a video is going to come out, that will help you out. All right, and let's see. Whew. Wow, these packs are kind of getting dry now. I mean, I'm still making coins, obviously, but it just, they're not, I mean, they were fire for a very, very short, oh, not short time, but they were fire for a little bit. And now it's kind of like, we're going to kind of diminish. So I don't know why they're not becoming as fire as they used to be. Okay. Actually, guys, I'm going to cut the video. Actually, you know what? I'm actually going to end the video right here then. And not just sold. So, I did start the video with 20K. With that 20K, once this Felt River sells and this other card sells, I will have, let's see how many coins I'll have after that. 42,000 plus about 1350 and about 7,000 minus 100. Okay. All right, so this is how much I'll have after all my cards sell. Now, again, I started the video with about 20,000, I say, and yeah, I did sell some cards from I did do some cards for my auction block or my trade block, not my trade block, my binder. And I'll cut the video real quick, and I'll be right back and tell you exactly how many coins I made. Hang on, guys. Guys, so what I did was I actually looked through in my video, and I actually saw that. So if I would have spent 2,500 on each of those golds, which I was putting in my, you know, putting in the sets for my binder, this is how much it would have been. Let me show you. I don't know if you guys can see that. You guys probably can't. Come on, focus. There we go. I started at 9K. I did the set three times for my binder. If I would have put 2,500 coins each time, as you can see, come on, focus again. Come on, focus. Come on, focus. You're not gonna focus, really? Come on. All right, there we go. It should be focused. You know, I'll just read it to you. I would have spent 2,500 coins, right? That's how much I was spending for each one of these sets. I made 18K off my first set. 2,500 coins, I made 3,800 coins. 2,500 coins, I made 1,600. So totally, I spent, if I would have, you know, bought the cards off the auction block, my binder, 7,500 coins I spent to make 23,400 coins back. Now with that, I made 5,500 coins back from sniping the cards on the auction house, and I spent about 2,000. I spent about 2,000 coins doing that. Or 3,000 coins, my bad. 3,000 coins doing it, made 5,500 back from the auction block from actually buying those cards and putting them in sets. For my binder, I made it back about 23,400? I believe so. Yeah, 23,400. So I made about 28,000 coins off this whole process, and I spent about 9K. So I'd say about... Yeah, I'd say about 9K, 23K, not 23K, 28K. I'm at about 19K currently in 42 minutes. So about 42 minutes, I made 19K off of it. Obviously, you could make a lot more coins. As you saw, I did pull in the Elite Badge to start the video. But, you know, if I didn't pull the Elite Badge, you know, it would be different, of course. But if I did pull the Elite Badge, with pulling the Elite Badge, is definitely makes a lot of difference. But you guys can pull Elite Badges too. It's not like, you know, just because I pulled an Elite Badge, oh my god, it's one in a million chance. Elite Badges are actually kind of more common than you might think. Now, with me making back 19k off of this card, I bought this for about 8 and I'm gonna sell for about 15, so I'm gonna make about 14k, let's say. I'm gonna make about 5k off that. So it's plus 5K. And then off this set, off this card, I bought this for about 6,100 and I'm gonna make back about 800 coins. So about 800 coins. So totally today, I made about 24,800 coins in this video. I'll take that. And it's not, honestly, I could do those sets for a lot cheaper, to be honest, if I just waited around and, you know, bought the cards for cheapest price possible. As you can see, some people put them up for 250 coins. And if you do this in during prime time hours, you can easily make, you know, you can make a lot of coins off this method. So definitely a great method, in my opinion. Give me a feedback down below what you guys think. But anyway, guys, that's pretty much it for this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure you slap that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Getting a good snipe. This is 1,400 coins. Yeah, I'll do it. Wait, no. My bad. I almost messed that up. That's the 86 overall edition, which... let's just sort it by rivers. Alright, I'll take it. I'll put it back up for 15k, and it most likely will sell. So guys, later on today, sometime later, you might be out when you're seeing this video. Pretty much what I'm going to do is I'm going to run down again how to overprice cards and stuff like that, and how to snipe and stuff, you know, kind of more broken down examples on how to snipe. So definitely, if you were watching this video, continue watching this video, and then once you're done, go ahead and go over to that video and check it out, because I'm going to, you know, really break down what players to snipe, you know, what exact players to snipe. Because a lot of people say, oh, you should, you know, snipe certain player, or say you should snipe, you know, any player you can, but nobody breaks down what's a snipe. And this is a good example right here, 6,400, 6,000, and as you see, if this card wasn't up and this was like zone 1-2, you could easily just buy this, and then the next one up with Slot Expert, you know, it's about, you know, 8K. So that's what you want to look for, is the chemistries. And sometimes it gets a little glitchy and you kind of can't see what the chemistries are, because sometimes you have to click on the card in order for it to load the chemistries. If it does, just click on the card, it will load the chemistries. But for example, 5,400, let's see what the next Dez Bryant Chain Movers, I think it's 6,000. So let's see. Okay, so 5,000 is the cheapest, and then 5,400 is the next. Now, I will talk about, you know, what exact cards to snipe again in another video, but this is pretty much the best way to snipe. And the way you're doing this, guys, is you're looking for one thing right here. You know, let's see if I can, let's break this down. All right, so as you can see, this is 770 coins. Minus that, I can easily make a profit. So we're gonna buy him for that price, and we'll sell him for 7,600. So it's obviously with this method, the issue is you're waiting for your card to sell, and you know you don't have many coins, so that is kind of an issue. Sadly, the silver method is no longer a thing. And obviously I'm doing this at like 1 o'clock in the morning, which is not a good time, but most of my videos I have to do at 1 o'clock in the morning due to other people in my house. You know, I gotta make sure the audio is all good, guys. So that's the issue with a lot of times, is I can't, you know, record at like 3 or 4 in the afternoon, which kind of sucks. But yeah, so let's actually see what the silver method is still going for, and let's see if it's actually decent. So silver packers are, it was all offense. Alright, so silver packers were selling for 8k, now they're selling for nothing, and most silvers will be selling for nothing. But the one thing I look at, guys, is... Guys, that Monkey Gamer back here from that video. Guys, definitely, welcome back to another episode of my sniping series. But real fast before I start, tell me how you guys like my thumbnails now. I'm kind of changing them up, and I'm making new type of thumbnails for all my videos. Definitely tell me down below how you like them. But anyway, guys, this video is long awaited. I actually got a comment about this a long time ago. And if I sound funny or weird in any way, I have like a pimple on my bottom of my tongue. So that's why I might sound a little weird. I might, you know, it might not sound my normal voice. Sorry about that, guys. I might, I might say some words like, you know, incorrectly or something like that. So sorry about that. It hurts like all heck to talk right now, but I have to make videos for you guys because I love making videos for you guys. I know you guys love these videos, so that's why I'm still making videos, but it does hurt to talk. So anyway, as I was saying, this video is long awaited. It's going to be how to snipe if you only have 20k or less. So if you're starting off and you know, you can, a lot of times sniping methods, they're kind of geared toward you have a lot of coins. And the whole, you know, idea of sniping is, you know, if you have a lot of coins, you can put a lot of coins into it and you can get a lot back. Now, obviously, we do have my Super Bowl method, sniping method. If you guys have not seen already, go back to my channel and check it out. But today what we'll be doing is just the basic sniping, because again, this is if you only have 20k, you're not going in, you know, you're not going in with all these coins, so you kind of have to, you know, try your best without spending a lot of coins. So basic methods again is just going from all offense, elite, and then bears, and then going to the next team after this. So just basic method, and what you really want to look for, guys, is chemistry. So as you see, vertical chemistry right here. Sometimes people just look up how much Andrew Whitworth is going for, and they'll see you going for 5,500, they put him up for 5,400, and the whole idea what you want to look for is right here, DT, so deep threat chemistry. If we look at right here, this is vertical, right? So if we see a DT at 5,400, we know we can buy it right away and sell for 6,400. So that's pretty much what you want to do, guys, is just go through and look at these chemistries. These chemistries are huge because a lot of these cards, they have multiple different editions of the same card because of the fact they have different chemistries. You know, they have a card with, you know, one card and another card, same exact way, they looked exactly the same, but they have an alternate chemistry. And a lot of people just throw them up for how much they're, you know, going for, technically not looking at what the chemistry version is going for. So that's something to look for whenever you're sniping, especially when you're this low on coins. Those kind of snipes happen a lot, and it's very efficient and it's very awesome because people just don't think about to look for what the chemistry version of their card is going for. They just want to look for, you know, what the normal version is, or whatever, you know, the lowest version on the auction block is. And sometimes that's not the case for, you know, you make coins back by just turning these into gold badges and then selling the gold badges. So this is secretly a great method. I just didn't think of this for so long. I mean, I know a lot of you guys are probably gonna comment down below and go, "Oh, I knew this method and I was doing this method. Why did you tell people?" I only tell people methods on how to make coins just so that I can help people make coins. I don't do it, you know, to hurt anybody who already is doing the methods. If I find a good method, guys, I'm gonna share it with you guys so you guys know about it and you guys can make some good coins off of it. But this is, honestly, this is actually not that bad of a method. And this is, seems like a very consistent method. Now, if my elite badge could sell, that'd be awesome. I might put it up for lower in a second. But, yeah, I don't know, guys. I definitely, you guys can tell me down below your opinion and what you guys are thinking about this method. Do you guys love it? Do you hate it? Do you think it's, like, you know, stupid or it's not worth it? Because if you can get these cards for 550 coins, which most of the time people are going to throw these up for very, very cheap, because gold cards have no set, you know, that actually make them expensive. This set right now is crazy, honestly. I mean, I'm making, if I was spending exactly what I was talking about, how much these sets go for, I'd be honest, I honestly would be making my coins back. Because again, 2,500 coins is how much it costs to do this whole entire set. So, you know, if you buy five of these, 550 coins each, which I did in the beginning of the video, let me put this up for lower because I think people are undercutting me. And with elite badges, I just try to sell them as quickly as possible. I don't really care about overpricing. You can't really overprice elite badges because there's nothing in elite, you know, there's no reason people are going to pay more for an elite badge just because, you know, you put it up. Because people put up elite badges all the time. There's nothing that can make elite badges, you know, be able to be overpriced. So that's why I don't care about overpricing elite badges, which I do on other, you know, cards. Now, same thing with my with this method. Now, the golds probably are the best idea to do. But again, you know, these might be okay. Bronzes probably won't be good at all, and they'll be useless. But silvers and golds definitely could be great. Wow, guys. I was just making this video, you know, just showing you guys how to snipe if you don't have that many coins. And it turned into now a amazing coin-making method that is just honestly crazy at this point. Because I didn't really think about this, you know? I didn't really think about, oh, yeah, right now the gold cards have no value. What to do with them? Put them in the sets. All right, let's go back. And now we're going to actually do this. Now we have a lot more coins. We have about... we're going to have about 35k after this. So let's go through. And again, just go... You want 550 and below. So for example, like this card. I should have bought that. I'm going to go back and buy that Bills card. But yeah, so you want 550 and below. 150 and below. So I spent about... probably about less than 2,500 on this. I mean, I spent about probably 2,200 on that whole entire set, and I made back about, I made it back easily the coins that, you know, I spent on it. Now I'm just gonna put this in a silver badge upgrade, and I'm gonna keep doing this. Guys, this is like free coins pretty much. I actually do have some gold I can just put on in this set, and that my badge just sold. So instantly I made back all my coins that I spent. Let me actually go to golds. I have a lot of golds. So I've been meaning to do this. So I guess this is probably the best time to do this is on a video for you guys to show you what I'm pulling out of these packs. So I'm not trying to put the Super Bowl players in the pack in these because they actually go for a good amount of coins. But let's see real fast. Guys. I'm not trolling. There's no EA fluking here. Let's see how much elite badges go for. But guys, this might be the best method to make coins. Wow. Okay, well, you heard it first. I just officially found out the method to make a lot of coins in this game. And sniping is not it right now. It is doing these sets. Wow. I don't know how long I'm gonna make this video because I want to keep doing these sets on video to show you guys how, you know, good these pulls are. Now remember, you get a guaranteed silver better. So you get guaranteed you make half of your coins back. There's no like, you know, like, oh, well, you make some of your coins back. No, you guaranteed to make at least half your coins back. And even more if you can, you know, get a good pull. And also if you can snipe them for, you know, very much or not that much. And the fact that people are throwing these cards up because golds have no value right now. This is a good day, guys. All right. Let's see. I can't put a card in there. Okay. Can't put him in there. Jay Cutler? I can. How much am I gonna get back on this one? A gold? A silver. So I'm pretty much getting a free gold every single time. And those things sell for 3,500 coins a piece, so I don't mind that. This set, I haven't even thought about doing this set. Like, usually the set isn't worth it because gold cards went for so much. But now the gold cards go for nothing because there's no point even doing anything with golds. This set is secretly going to become the best set in the game. Alright, what did I pull out of this one? And each of these sets, technically speaking, would cost me 2,500 coins. So, for example, this is a good example. But the thing is, I can put these in here, and I can actually... We might be getting a Man of the Month set. It's not confirmed in any kind of way. And obviously, I don't know. But I'm just assuming we might be getting a Man of the Month set. So, that might be a thing. The one thing I look at is, how much are these... How much are gold badges going for? Gold badges has to be going for crap. They have to be going really, really, yeah. So we have 3,200, which is actually, that's actually how much they go for. Let me do math. Let me do some math real fast, guys. How much are silvers going for? 6,800. Okay, they're going for like about the same. What I'm saying, guys, is because golds are going for nothing. And there's a gold player set that has, you put gold players in and you get badges back. And right now, if they're going for nothing, 5 golds equals 2 badges. And it's guaranteed silver or better. So you're guaranteed 1,600 coins. If that's the case, and you can buy, yeah, it's only gonna cost you 2,700 coins. You're guaranteed to make more than half your coins back with the chance of getting a gold or elite that, you know, you could easily make a lot of coins back. Let's try this out, guys. So, this actually could be the new method, especially until they release a set. Right now, there's no set, you know, that actually made golds valuable. So, they're all just plummeting in price and they go for nothing. But if you guys can come on here and actually snipe some of these gold players, you could probably make a lot of coins off of this. Because honestly, at this point, like, if you can, you know, snipe these gold players and actually get some coins back. I mean, not get some coins back. You can actually make some good coins off these. Because if you can pull one gold badge, you automatically make your coins back. And if people are going to put these up for like 450 coins and, you know, 350, 250, and you can just come on here. And I mean, if you can complete the set for even cheaper than what I was talking about at like, you know, 2,000 coins, this actually might be the best method in the game right now. I mean, you might, if you can complete the set for less than 1,600, you're making your coins 10 out of 10 times back. And that's just a fact. Like, you, okay, I did not mean to rhyme there. That's just a fact. And you're going to make your coins back and everything's going to be great. Nah. Alright, but yeah, I'm like, you can honestly, if you can make coins back 10 out of 10 times, this actually might be the best. So, again, let's see. Actually, let me go back and see how much I have. Again, you only need to buy 5, which I don't know why I thought 10. I'm thinking about how the set used to be. Now that the set is only 5, what's the point of not doing this set? Like, this set honestly just might be free money. Okay, we'll see. Go to newest. Alright, so these, I bought these all for 500.